There's great ways to brew in large quantities now. It ties to some advances that have happened in pulse brewing, and with that you can control the contact time.
Can you tell us, just tell us what pulse brewing is?
Sure.
Remind us what pulse brewing means.
It's the ability to control the contact time. We know great cups of coffee, of the 30% that's possible, have extractions of 18 to 22%. And what that allows you to do is to get great body in the cup, but not over-extract. So mm-hmm. at a time, there was always a concern that when you went into large volume brewing, that you might not be able to get the same quality. And there's a lot of effort now to do great coffee in single cup all the way to large volume brewing.
So I'm just trying to imagine it, and this is me as rewriting my book, which I'm always doing.
Yeah.
So in a previous large scale volume, it would be one long pour, right? It would be a certain number of minutes, and the steep time would be controlled. But you're saying pulse is briefly at a time. The water comes in, and then how long does it last? And you were talking yesterday about different formulas for different kinds of coffee.
What the specialty roaster does is they work with the equipment manufacturer prior to the equipment ever getting on site, and they know their coffee so well. It's like being the conductor in a symphony. They know what they want to get out of that coffee. So what they do is they utilize the parameters that are built into equipment. So there's things like pre-infusion, fill pauses, controlling the overall contact time, all those things, they set those parameters to make a recipe for that coffee. So then when it goes operationally, the operator can be pushing a button, but behind that button is a lot of technology.